lucky can one guy be? I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head?
Hey Scott, why are you talking about a crappy game from 10 years ago? Fallout 3 was better. Where are the Dota videos? Why are you such a dingus? Wah, wah, wah. Listen, I'll make whatever videos I want to make, and I really want to talk about New Vegas since the 10-year anniversary is coming up. I want to revisit this game as I enjoyed it immensely, and I want to convince other people who might have missed this incredible experience to go back and maybe give it a try. I promise you, if you give this game a chance, it will show you a great time.
You play as a courier delivering a special item across the Mojave Wasteland. On your way to the Strip, you were attacked by men looking to steal your package. You are shot in the head but survive. From there, it's your job to track these men down and enact your revenge. Or not. One of the strengths of New Vegas is the freedom and agency allowed to you, the player. Once you're set free into the world, you can pretty much go anywhere you want to, whether you are prepared for it or not.
If you're like me, then in a game called New Vegas, you'd want to go right to the Strip from Good Springs, but you'd be incorrect. If you go north from Good Springs, you will run into all manner of killer bugs, a nest of rape incarnate on two legs, and junkies. Avoid them if you can. Instead, you need to head south and go all the way around the map, running between settlements. While on your roundabout road trip, you meet the many denizens of the world and get to know them. Many of them give you quests that require you to travel to the next town over, making sure you visit most of the major settlements in the world early on.
By completing these quests, you are given the resources to deal with the next area.
Speaking of quests, some of the quests here are amazing. Each one of them flesh out the world and have you go exploring a new area. Let's take the Good Springs quest as an example.
If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
What the hell is your problem?
It's a perfect vertical slice of the game. It's set up as a smaller version of the main quest. You can side with the townsfolk or with the gang. If you side with the townsfolk, you can convince them to better equip themselves if you pass the right skill checks. Or, if you really want to, you can side with the gang and take over the town. Each option has a different reward. If you help the town, you get a discount at the stores there. If you help the gang, they won't attack you out in the world. One thing I really like about this game is that while there might be a linear progression that the story wants you to follow, you have the agency to choose how to go about it. You can follow orders or be completely chaotic. Unlike, for example, a Rockstar game, there is only one fail state in New Vegas, and that's when you die. You can kill anyone in the game, you can be the most hated person in the wasteland, but the world keeps going. The game forces you to live with your choices. Weapons, perks, and stats all let you build your character the way you want, which leads to more freeform roleplaying. You can be a smooth-talking cowboy, an intelligent scientist, or giant idiot that punched thing good. To put it in perspective, in this game, a charisma build where you just talk people down is just as viable as shooting people. If you want, you can play as a pacifist and not kill anything. It's how powerful speech is. For example, in my first playthrough, I was a dumb teenager and I rushed through the house storyline and didn't do many side quests. I entered the Lickett's camp at level 16. I did not survive long. I had to go back to a previous save, power level my speech skill, as I could not fight the Lickett one-on-one to win the game. Lesson learned. There are a lot of characters in New Vegas, and they have some of the best lines I've ever heard in a game. Except for the Raiders. The Raiders are awful. You're like a sight of your own blood.
Quack doctors can say what they want about all the rad scorpion stings that done pierced my skull, and I know what I seen. Work of the chupacabra, the livestock vampire, says Nobark, but they don't pay no mind. Too many holes, they say, and there's bullets in them. Well, says Nobark, we got a chupacabra with an automatic weapon. And that's when they get real quiet, because now they see the predicament we're in.
You want a reason? How about four? They're called bodyguards, and every one of them is packing. Me too, so baby makes five. Add to that, every chairman in this joint is armed, and not with some holdout pea shooter like maybe you smuggled through security. Anyhow, baby, you didn't come here for vengeance. You came to get clued in.
I'm gonna be honest, the gunplay in New Vegas does not carry the game. This is not Call of Duty Shoot a Man. The writing and environment do much of the heavy lifting. For instance, some of the best writing comes from followers who come along on your adventures. You really get attached to these guys. You can help them deal with their own problems and issues, and in return, you get powerful upgrades from them. This being a Fallout game, there are many places to go and things to see. New Vegas has got to have some of the best environmental storytelling I've ever seen, to the point where the places are as much a character as the people. When you go into Nobark's shack, you can see he has mannequins wearing helmets as if to guard the door. There's empty soda glass bottles hung up from the ceiling, there's a rigged shotgun pointed at the door. You can tell this is the shack of a crazy man. One of my favorite places is the Brock Flower Cave. I go there every playthrough for the unique weapon. When you enter the cave, you would think there's not much, just some giant rats and containers of radioactive waste. But if you explore enough, you can find someone's old hideout. Based on the medical equipment on the table, I think that a long time ago a doctor was hiding out here and he was operating on himself or another person. There are a lot of old cans in the back of the room, so he was here for a long time. But something clearly happened as the door was blasted off from the outside. There's no corpse, and the duffel bag by his bed was empty. So I believe he was taken somewhere by somebody. All of that from the environment. No one told me that. No one told me to come here. There's no quest attached to this place. No NPC, audio log, or note left behind. All of that was implied by the environment. But your reward for exploring is a bunch of medical supplies and a sick custom weapon. New Vegas is probably one of the most immersive games I've ever played. People in the world come together in such a way that it just feels right. And if you ever get bored of what's in the base game, you can download a ton of community-made content. Mods are possibly the reason why this game is still so popular. If there's an aspect of the game you don't like, there's probably a mod that fixes or changes it. Mods make New Vegas worth picking up even 10 years later. For as much praise I've heaped on New Vegas, there are some issues. It's a Bethesda open world. It crashes. Sometimes there is just one particle too many and shit just fucking dies. New Vegas is a really long game with a slow burn at the beginning. It's a bit of a commitment. It demands your full attention and hours invested for you to get the most out of it. This is more I'm an idiot rather than the game's fault. I'm on an old save that I haven't played in about a year. I wanted to show off some of the unique one-of-a-kind weapons I had on that save, but 2019 Ska stashed them somewhere because of weight limitations. 2020 Ska has no idea where these weapons are. I'm quite annoyed that some of the best weapons in the game are probably hidden under a rock somewhere, and like a squirrel hiding a nut, I can't remember where they are. So, the billion-dollar question. Does Fallout New Vegas hold up today? Just barely. While I personally love this game, I think it's a tough sell to people who aren't really into an open-world Bethesda RPG. If you like Skyrim or Fallout 3, this is a jam. Don't disregard this one because you think it's a spin-off game. New Vegas stands up and above any other Bethesda game, in my opinion. Final score. Go play this game out of 10. It's like 10 bucks, 20 with all the DLC, wait for it to go on sale or something. Go play it, download it, slap some mods on that bad boy, and go to town. Thanks for watching. More to come. Okay, thanks, bye.